Hi my dear students, in this video we are going to discuss about reluctance start induction motor. So this is generally a reluctance motor, simply called a reluctance motor or reluctance start induction motor. See, in this we have a stator as well as rotor. This is called a stator and this is called a rotor. Simply, the stator having concentrated winding and projected poles or salient poles. Concentrated winding and projecting poles. The projecting poles are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Like these 6 are the projecting poles. And these poles having a concentrated winding. And this is my rotor. The rotor doesn't have any winding. For example, my rotor having like a 4 poles. It doesn't have a winding. But due to only the reluctance, the rotor will start rotation. Simply, due to only the reluctance, that's why this is called a reluctance start induction motor. Here, generally, the torque is produced due to, or the rotor should reduce the reluctance. This is the principle in this machine. Always the rotor trying to reduce the reluctance in between stator poles. See here, for example, here my rotor pole and the stator pole completely same in position. Here also my rotor pole and stator pole completely same in position. This is called fully aligned position. What is that? Aligned position. But see here, my rotor is exactly in between of 2 poles of stator. What is that? My rotor is in between 2 poles of my stator, exactly in middle. And here also my rotor pole is in between middle of the stator poles. Here the reluctance is maximum. Here the reluctance is maximum because of maximum air gap. When air gap is maximum, reluctance is maximum. Then my rotor trying to reduce that reluctance. When rotor trying to reduce this reluctance, then our rotor should rotate like this. When this pole comes exactly in the position of second, here reluctance will reduce. As well as when this pole exactly in the same position of the 5th pole, then here also reluctance reduces. When these 2 reluctance reduces, again these 2 reluctance increases. Again what happened? Again my rotor trying to reduce reluctance. Again my rotor trying to reduce the reluctance. Like continuously the rotor will rotate and rotate and rotate continuously. From high reluctance to low reluctance, high reluctance to low reluctance, from unaligned position to aligned position, unaligned position to aligned position. Like that my rotor is trying to rotate. Before that, actually we have to give the supply to this winding, stator winding. Actually it should produce the flux. It should produce the flux. The flux should rotate somewhat advanced to this rotor. If my flux is in advanced state, then my rotor also following that flux which produced in the stator. This is simply the operation of this reluctance start induction motor. Generally, in this machine, we have two types. One is synchronous reluctance motor, other one is switched or variable reluctance motor. Synchronous reluctance motor, nothing but, what is that? actually our sail and pole. I said you already, sail and pole motor. If in this sail and pole motor, the stator should be given by three phase AC supply. Stator should be given by three phase AC supply, which produces the magnetic field, which rotates in clockwise direction with synchronous speed. But the poles or the field winding should not be connected to any supply. Simply, the excitation to this machine is zero because the reluctance machine rotor doesn't need any winding. Simply, the reluctance is the process here. We have to reduce the reluctance here. So, my rotor trying to catch this one. Like that, our rotor will rotate in the same direction. So, this is a synchronous-based reluctance motor. In this, generally the sail and pole machine act as a synchronous reluctance motor. But this is not possible for cylindrical because here the pole should be in sail and pole. And here, generally this is the synchronous reluctance motor. The rotor winding should not be connected to excitation. When it comes to switched, once again, here, the condition is that number of poles in the stator should be equals to number of poles in the rotor in this machine. When the number of poles in the stator equals to number of poles in the rotor, then only this motor will rotate at speed of ns. Otherwise, the synchronous reluctance motor should not operate. Actually, we know that even in induction machine and synchronous machine, the poles should be equals to synchronous stator and rotor poles should be equal. This is the concept of synchronous reluctance motor. We are coming to this one. The number of poles in the stator should be somewhat greater than the number of poles in the rotor. This is the condition for variable reluctance motor. Or switched reluctance motor. Here the number of poles in the stator is a 6 and number of poles in the rotor is a 4. Like that it should be. Then our rotor trying to catch it and our rotor trying to reduce the reluctance. Like that my rotor is continuously rotating in this machine. This is switched variable reluctance motor. Then, where we are using this switched reluctance or this simply reluctance motor, what are the applications of reluctance motor? Simply, the analog meters generally used this reluctance motor, and timers and counters, and hard disk drives, and control rod drive in a nuclear power plant. In nuclear power plant, the control rod mechanism also driven by reluctance motor only. So, the applications of reluctance motor, analog meters, timers and counters, hard disk drives and control rod mechanism. These are the applications. Right, sir? So, simply, this is simply about the reluctance motor. We have two types, synchronous reluctance and switched reluctance. This is also called like a stepwise. Stepped machine. This is also called stepper motor like that. Stepper motor like that also they will call it as. Okay guys, are you clear now? Right sir.